video. I'll share with you the cost, kind of go everything with you, just because I really like doing that to kind of break down so you can see how mine works when it comes to meal planning on a budget. So if you're new to my channel, my name is Miranda, and my favorite way to make rice for the last couple months is just on the stovetop. It's super easy. It takes no time at all. It always turns out perfect. 2 cups of water, 1 cup of rice, add a little bit of seasoning or salt. I'm using this carne asada seasoning. Bring it to a boil. After it comes to a boil, turn the heat down to low, put a lid on it, cook it for 10 to 12 minutes, turn the heat off, put it like somewhere else on the stove, let it sit for 5 to 7 minutes. It's perfect every time. So this video is gonna be more like vlog style in the way I'm setting up and cooking and chopping, because I really wanted to just enjoy the time being in my kitchen. I really love to cook and chop. I really love to make sure there's no bugs on my lettuce. You'll have to pause and read that if you didn't. I'm scarred for life. Anyways, I just really like to take the time, and when I watch other people's videos, I like to see them doing everything. That inspires me. It motivates me to see them cut and chop and wash and be in their kitchen and clean their kitchen. So that's kind of the content I like to make. I also just want to mention, normally I wash my veggies with cold water. I let them soak and then do distilled white vinegar, but this day I just kind of rinsed everything and I felt like I was good to go. But typically I'll like fill my sink with water or a bowl with water, a little bit of vinegar, and this lettuce was actually so delicious. So I shopped at Albertsons this day. It's kind of been my go-to. I haven't been really going to Smith's recently. I don't know. I just feel like the produce there just isn't as good. But between Albertsons and Trader Joe's, I've been feeling like they have the best prices overall, the best deals. And if you are someone who is looking to eat healthy for cheap, I really recommend is also downloading the Fetch app. This is not sponsored. They have sponsored my content before, but I talked about them for almost 2 years before they even knew who I was. But I actually get a lot of points over on Fetch, and I can turn them into rewards, and recently we've been turning them into movie rewards. So if you don't have the Fetch app, you'll see a link down below for it. I got 100 bonus points just for scanning a receipt from Albertsons. If you don't have an Albertsons near you, no big deal. There's probably a different grocery store that's in your app. It's just based on where you are. They have the same going on for Vons right now. And I've noticed that every time I go to Albertsons and every time I go to Vons, I get an extra 100 points. And that adds up really quickly. All right, let's get down to talking about the food. So I really like using the same ingredients over and over and over and making really simple recipes. And I think sometimes it does come with a little bit of food fatigue or food rut, because I go to the grocery store and I'm like, I'm kind of tired of salads, or I'm kind of tired of rice. But then there's sometimes that I get all the same ingredients I always get, and it turns out fantastic. So I made this little like quesadilla, if you will. I don't even think it would be like a quesadilla. It's like a little wrap. One of the best lunch ideas I've ever had. So this isn't really specific, something you could really make ahead if you wanted to be crunchy, but it really only took a couple of minutes in a frying pan. I think it was like 2 minutes per side. It was so crispy. The beans were warm, and I'm obsessed with tomatoes, always have been since I was a little kid. And it just had like the right amount of acidity to it. It was awesome. I'm like, okay, I could probably eat this for a couple weeks straight before I get sick of it. And I can also think of so many different things you can put inside of it. So definitely not something you can really take on the go with you unless you do like a cold wrap, but that would still really be good. And I'll share with you what kind of that full plate that I put together. So these avocados weren't 100% ready. They were really squishy on the outside, but then when I opened them up on the inside, they were really firm. So I may do with it. I know if you add a little bit of salt and a little bit of acid to the avocado, it'll help it break down a little bit faster. And I decided to step away from trying to mash it with a fork, and I just popped it in my food processor and we were good to go. And you're also gonna see me, like I said, this is more vlog style, behind the scenes, washing, wiping down. If something that you are intimidated by is food prep, because it does end up with a lot of dishes. My friend Alyssa just said this the other day. If you are making meals homemade, just expect to have a lot of dishes. You can have your husband help. You can have your kids help. You can have your partner help. If it's just you, cleaning as you go is like a huge, huge tool. So like I said, for the guacamole, I was really struggling with getting it smashed. So I added a little bit of salt, had the acidity from the tomato. If you can't have tomato, you could do onion, cilantro, a little red pepper in there would be really good. And then I use this little hand mixer I have, or it's like a food processor, but there's no cord. It's awesome. I will link it down below so you can check it out. but made some quick guac. And I have always had a problem with avocado, but recently I've been introducing more fats to my diet and it has not been bothering me. So I've just been having a little bit of it every single day. I eat a high carb, lower fat, plant-based diet. And avocado for the past couple years has really bothered me, but now if I have a little bit of it, I'm fine. And I had a little bit of it every single day this week. So there you go. So also I do want to mention too, is I did have more than one can of beans. You'll see at the end when I share my full grocery shopping list, and I had 2 pounds of rice. And this ended up being 6 days of lunches because I have a really long work day. I'm typically at work for about 12 hours, so I technically have 2 lunches every day, but it's 12 lunches in total. So if you're someone who just eats 1 lunch a day, this will give you a lot of ideas or a shopping list to carry you through about 2 weeks. So here is the burrito bowl that I did. Again, something really, really simple, just some cool lettuce to add some crispiness, the rice, guac, beans. The guac, I only made half of it in advance, and for the rice, I just made enough for 2 days at a time. You don't have to eat leftover rice if you don't want to. I always get people back and forth in my comments about it. I don't have a problem with it, so I make it ahead of time. And for the quesadilla, I just made it fresh every single day, but this was such a delicious lunch, and if you try it, you'll have to let me know. I'm really curious if it's something that you are a fan of in your own house, or if this is something that would be like a dinner or a lunch for you. It was just really easy, really simple, and again, using all the same ingredients I always use. So here's my cost. As you can see, one of the biggest things here is the romaine lettuce was free. I used my store perks for the romaine, so I got it for free. So it brings down my lunches to $1.23 per lunch. That's really, really inexpensive, and overall, even if you had to add the lettuce in, it would only be a couple extra dollars. Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back. I am so happy you clicked on today's video. I have 10 meal ideas to share with you when you don't feel like cooking. And they range from like the easiest thing in the world to a little bit of complication to kind of reignite that fire. So the first one is a bento box style meal, basically a snack meal. I do this a lot for lunches, because if I don't have something pre-made for lunches, I don't want to cook something. And a lot of you know, if you watch a lot of my videos, time after time I tell you, I basically meal prep everything on a Sunday, but like sometimes we eat through things faster. And this style meal, you can do whatever with. You can add any kind of veggies or dip, crackers, chips, whatever you have, just a bento style. That's basically blankets for everything. But like I said, this is just a really quick meal. It takes 2 seconds to put together, and you didn't even have to cook. The next meal idea is, I actually been doing this recently, but I did this a lot years ago. I take an instant pack of oatmeal that is flavored and a scoop of protein. My protein is linked below if you want to check it out, but it is so good. And there's basically no cooking involved, I don't think, when you use a microwave. So, you know, because you're not really doing anything. The microwave's doing all the work. And if you don't use a microwave, that's okay. Use your stovetop. Make oatmeal however you want. But this is just something really, really easy. And for me, it's got a lot of protein in it, so I can have it after a run or late at night when I'm really hungry. And I have a lot of flavor from this apple cinnamon oatmeal, but you can use any kind that you like. And it's perfect. It's like the best meal. All right, meal number 3 idea is hummus and pasta. If you've never tried this combination together, you are missing out. So this is basically like mac and cheese for adults, but you can add a ton of veggies to it if you want. Once the water starts boiling, you can definitely add some frozen veggies, or you can add some fresh veggies, chop them up. But if we're being honest here, most of the time, if I don't feel like cooking, I'm just going to have a salad, because I can just take some lettuce out of the refrigerator, put some dressing on it, and have some greens. But basically, you're just going to take some of your hummus, and once your pasta's cooked, you're going to mix it all together, and it's super creamy. I like to add a little bit of the pasta water and some red chili flakes to that red pepper hummus. It's so good. It's a little bit spicy and very sweet and very creamy. Do me a favor and leave your I don't want to cook meal ideas down below. I did this on Instagram and I got over 400 responses. I'm not sharing all of them with you today, but I'm sharing a lot of them. Okay, here's a meal that I use a lot of times for my husband, but I used to use all the time for myself before I decided to go gluten-free. So just a packet of ramen. You don't have to use the ramen flavor if you are plant-based or vegan. You can just use the noodles and some stir-fry veggies. I cook them together in the same pot once the water is boiling and add some soy sauce at the end. Meal number 5 is your basic noodles and red sauce. This is the only time that I make noodles and red sauce at our house is when I don't feel like cooking. It's a staple in my pantry. I can pull it out, start up some boiling water, and throw on some red sauce. And recently I've been throwing in those ground crumbles for my husband. So basically I have a protein, a carb, and a veggie, because yes, tomatoes are veggies, right? Or are they fruits? I don't know. They're delicious. I don't really care what they are, but that's the only time I use the basic noodles and red sauce, and it works for us. Another staple, canned soup. You can use jar soup too, but anytime you have a soup on hand, it's perfect to use when you don't feel like
meal
cooking.
Idea
this number eight, oats and fruit. You can use frozen fruit, fresh fruit, dried fruit, just some quick oats or steel oats. I like to use quick oats because I like the texture of them so much better, but I'm trying to share a lot of sweet and savory ideas because I know we don't always have the same taste for whatever we want at the same time. Meal number nine is the good old avocado toast. Recently, I've been able to eat avocado again, and I am so excited. It's been like 3 years since I could really eat it, and I've been introducing it a little bit every single day, and now I can eat like almost a whole avocado and be totally fine. So hello. What's up with that? I don't know, but hopefully that doesn't change. Anyways, I had some beautiful ripe avocado. You can also get the single packs if you want to, so that way they aren't going bad. That's one thing I don't like about avocado. You look at it 1 second, it's like never going to be ready, and then you blink and it's rotten. Add some everything seasoning if you want to, or some red chili flakes and sea salt, also a go-to, and go ahead and just load it up. You can put some veggies on this. You can have some hummus on the side with some veggies. You can do a salad. I feel like it's good just as it is because it's super calorie dense and super filling and really nutritious. I feel like avocado just doesn't get enough credit unless you're on the West Coast. Anyways, this was so good. This was actually my dinner this evening because hi, I didn't feel like cooking. What do you know when I'm making this video? Meal idea number 10 is my absolute favorite. I feel like I haven't made this in so long, but I shared this a lot in my What I Eat in a Day videos when I first went plant-based way back when I started my channel. Go ahead and take a sweet potato, doesn't matter what kind, and put it in a paper towel. That's how I like to do things. You can do it your way. I pop it in the microwave, potato button. I have two sizes, small or large, and I just did the small, so it took 2 minutes, 45 seconds. Then I usually take a fresh banana, but I didn't have any on hand, so thank you, past Miranda, for thinking of future Miranda and always having frozen bananas on hand. I take about a whole frozen banana, put the rest back in the freezer for later, and I zip that banana in the microwave for about 30 seconds. Once the potato's done, I cut it open, smash it, take the banana, mash it up, put it on top of the sweet potato, and then add the glorious sunflower butter. Now, you can use any kind of nut butter that you like. You can add other things too, like maple syrup, maybe some nuts. My friend Courtney just shared one that she made, and it was a banana, I believe, on top with pecans, cinnamon, and a little maple syrup. Like what? That's basically dessert in a meal. And it's so healthy, so good for you because you're getting so many nutrients and it's really filling. And guess what? You didn't have to cook it. All you had to do is basically put something in the microwave. And if you have leftover sweet potatoes on hand, this is another go-to for a lunch or a dinner. Hey, 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 please do me a huge favor and let me know what you're having for lunch this week. I love asking because it gets so many ideas going in the comments section. So this is my favorite brand of tofu, and I can only find it at Winco Foods. I do like the Trader Joe's tofu, the extra firm. It tastes identical, but this brand was like the first brand that I had that I was like, okay, I like it. So I'm just cutting it into large cubes. I don't press my tofu. If that's how you prefer it, you can do that. I feel like with the extra firm, I don't need to. Also, I'm just lazy and don't have a tofu press and don't really care that much. But I'm going to go ahead and pop this in my oven at 350 degrees for about 30 minutes and just make it nice and crispy on the outside. I'm going to add some seasoning. I believe I added a barbecue seasoning this day. It says seafood blend. Yes, but it's not. This Auntie Nono's is so good. I have a bunch of different seasonings from them and I like to use them all the time. This is probably my favorite. It's like a barbecue inspired seasoning. It's really good for summertime, I feel like. But we are making a salad and I put that salad dressing back. Okay, sometimes when I do budget videos, I feel bad spending $5 on a dressing because I'm like, oh, I should probably make this, you know, video as cheap as possible. You know, what if someone doesn't have the extra $5? What if they're coming to me for ideas and, you know, that's out of their budget? So I didn't get the dressing. We have dressings on hand, as I'm sure everybody has condiments in their fridge. Oh, I do have a question to ask you. Would you like to see a video that is a use it up video, but instead of focusing on the food I want to use up, instead the condiments that are in my fridge that like have barely anything left, because I feel like that would be a really fun spin on like a use it up. Say, you know, I have this condiment and, you know, it inspired me to make this meal. Let me know down below. So anyways, as you saw, I just cut up some cucumbers and lettuce, and I am going to add a paper towel to each of these containers. And you're probably thinking, why are you prepping these salads? Well, for us, a lot of times we don't eat food like normally. And I say this all the time. I like to meal prep on the weekend when I have time. And sometimes this food only lasts us till Wednesday. But if their salads are on hand, we can take them out and eat them. And sometimes we might have two salads a day. I'm not the only person eating these meals. But me and my husband will enjoy these, and everything's kind of like bulk meal prepped, and then it's just really simple. Sometimes we'll even have a salad for breakfast because it's there, it's ready, it's convenient, and the paper towels do keep the lettuce and cucumbers fresh. I just turn them upside down in my refrigerator, and then the tofu I just kind of bulk prepped. And here is the salad. And I had leftover condiments of dressing, but I also had some limes and lemons on hand, and that's what I used for this salad this day. It was super fresh. I added a little bit of salt. It was just like so good, like the perfect summer salad. So let's move on to dinner. We're going to say breakfast for last just because I just wanted to switch it up this day. So for dinner, I decided to make egg rolls, but I didn't realize for some reason that the egg rolls weren't gluten-free. I just like wasn't thinking that when I went to the store. Now, personally, I do try to eat gluten-free, just my preference, because my body doesn't really like love gluten. I don't have celiac, but if I eat too much gluten, it's just not fun for my body. So I decided to go ahead and make egg rolls, but we already had some dinner plans for the week, and I thought, you know what? I'm going to make these and freeze these. However, I totally forgot to share with you after I froze them, kind of like how I stored them. So I made the egg rolls, sweet potatoes, squash, black beans, corn, and I stuffed each of them, and then I put them on a baking sheet and ended up transferring them to another baking sheet, because you'll see it that I was going to put them into the oven, but then changed my mind because I was using the baking sheet that the tofu was on. So I moved them. I put them in the freezer in the baking sheet, like on the baking sheet, so that way that they could freeze really nicely. And I didn't put them in my kitchen fridge. We got a fridge for our garage, and I'm going to do a full stock with me, and it's going to be really fun. I'm going to do a freezer meal prep, and I'm excited for that, so make sure you subscribe. But I went ahead and put those long sheets of egg rolls into that freezer, let them freeze overnight, pulled them out. They were on parchment paper, put them in, put the egg rolls in some Ziploc baggies, and now I have a whole freezer full of egg rolls. It's really nice, actually. And then my husband can take those out and he can put them in the oven or the air fryer, whatever he wants to enjoy them. So let's get back to the sweet potatoes and zucchini here. I added them to just a skillet, and I added about a half a cup of water and put the lid on, and that kind of really steamed them. And I went ahead and added the zucchini because that would release its water and then just cook the sweet potatoes really fast. This really only took about 10 or 12 minutes, super fast, and then they were nice and soft to put into the egg rolls. As far as the black beans and corn, I just drained them. I didn't rinse them because I did want a little bit of liquid in there so that way they would cook really nicely. I think the only thing that my husband really, really missed from this was like a dipping sauce. So next time I am going to make him a dipping sauce, but having those egg rolls on hand was like really, really nice because he could just pop them into the, like I said, the air fryer, and he could add them to his lunch if he wanted to. And they're really inexpensive. And you're going to see this makes so much for 20 egg rolls to stuff. Like, it was incredible to me. We actually had leftovers, and I had that with some of my salads, and it was just like really good. So I actually loved the process of putting these egg rolls together. I don't know what it is. Sometimes I don't like little tasks that are time consuming, but then sometimes I just absolutely love it. And also this egg roll wrapper was so hard to open. I couldn't find my kitchen scissors. Let me know down below. Is your kitchen scissors go missing all the time? I have three of them. They're all gone. I don't know where they went. But anyways, going back to the egg rolls, I actually love putting these together. It was like super fun. I had the time to do it. And like I said, sometimes I don't like doing little tasks like this. I try to make things like in bulk that are really easy, really simple, not super time consuming. This wasn't super time consuming. It was just easy and fun, and it only took like 5 minutes to put them all together. But it did have extra stuffing, and so that was nice, so we could enjoy that. And I don't know. It was just kind of fun. I was just thinking of all the different things I could put into egg rolls. I was thinking like a buffalo chickpea would be really, really good. Do like chickpeas, buffalo sauce, maybe a little mustard, and, you know, add some veggies in there, maybe some celery, maybe some green peppers. Be really super good. Or you could do like a buffalo cauliflower if you wanted to. Just like a ton of different options. I don't know. It sounded really good. So here's what I was talking about. You can see I was going to bake the one on the left, but I decided not to. I moved everything to the same tray, put it in the freezer, and like I said, froze it overnight, and then put it in little baggies, and they were good to go. So moving on to breakfast. So for breakfast, I decided to do a oatmeal bake. That should be no surprise. I do them almost every single week because they're really, really easy. They're convenient. The oatmeal's made ahead, but I did decide to put zucchini in this one, and it was okay. I put banana in it as well. I don't love the taste or the texture when you put veggies like zucchini or cauliflower with oats. A lot of you always say like it doesn't change the texture. I'm wondering if it's because I use quick oats and I know what I'm expecting that it does change the texture. Maybe if I use like steel cut or old fashioned, maybe it wouldn't be the same. But I'm using my little blender and getting my zucchini all blended up. And I didn't even add any additional water or anything to this recipe. You could add water, you could add nut milk. I didn't add anything additional because the zucchini is so wet that if you let the oats sit for a little bit with the zucchini and then mix up with the banana, it should be good. But you can add a little bit of liquid if you want. So I would say that was about 3 cups of zucchini, 2 bananas, and I'm going to use 2 cups of oatmeal. This is something I feel like you just can't mess up. You just mix it all together. If it's a little too dry, add a little liquid. If it's a little too wet, add a little bit more oats. You cannot mess this up. It's not an exact science. It's not a real baked recipe. It's just adding stuff to a bowl, mixing it together, putting it in the oven, baking it, and then you're good. And I like the bulk section at Winco Foods. I get this question all the time, but I don't like love it because sometimes I get kind of creeped out by it. Just thinking like it's bulk and, you know, everyone's in there getting their food. I don't know. Sometimes I'm like okay with it. And then some days I'm like, I don't think I'm going to get any bulk items today. But I used to shop the bulk section all the time when I did other budget videos. And then sometimes I would feel bad because people would say like they didn't have the bulk options. And then I just kind of got to the point where I was like, I can't control where everybody else shops. This is just for ideas. Unless you live in the same city as me, shop at the same stores, it's almost impossible to get things exactly the same. But I try to use ingredients that are really easy to get, pantry staples, if you will, that I know people can get, you know, maybe the egg roll wrappers aren't a pantry staple for many people, but oats, zucchini, bananas, sweet potatoes, I feel like all those are like just staples that you can get and recreate these recipes. So anyways, I put this in a glass baking dish, put it in the oven at 350 and baked it for about 25 to 30 minutes until it was crispy to my liking. And this I would only cut into 4. And sometimes my husband, if he were to eat this, he would take 2 pieces. So it's not very much, if you will. It's only 4 servings, but it's really, really delicious. And it's something we both love. And like I said, I can have it on hand. And then breakfast, lunch, and even the dinner is set for the week. And that's all I'm looking to do when I meal prep is get everybody set for the week. Welcome back to another video, or welcome if you are new here. If you are new, do me a huge favor, give this video a huge thumbs up and subscribe. Today I'm going to share with you this amazing $3 dinner. It's honestly the best $3 dinner that I have ever made, and it definitely needs to be made in your kitchen. It takes no time at all. Plus, I'm going to share with you a simple, easy bread recipe that you can amp this meal up with and show you my homemade veggie broth. So this video is packed. Sit down, buckle up, let's get started. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to prep these garbanzo beans. You can definitely use them in a can if you want to, but I figured I saved 4 times the amount of money making them myself, but you don't have to if you don't have the time. They're really awesome to prep ahead. I prepped a whole pound of them in my Instant Pot. If you don't have an Instant Pot or a pressure cooker, as I guess mine is, it's not technically an Instant Pot. I always just use that slang because everybody knows what it is. If you don't have a pressure cooker, you can make them in your crock pot or you can make them stovetop. Head over to Pinterest and find a quick recipe. For me, I just rinse them. I check them for rocks really quickly and then I get them in my pressure cooker and it takes 30 minutes, about a 10-minute release, I think is what my pressure cooker does for a bean method, and they are perfection every single time. You can also save the aquafaba if you want to use it later on in recipes. It freezes really well, and I put 6 cups of water with my beans, in case you want to know. And I always use that method with every style of bean that I make, and every time it's perfection. But like I said, if you don't want to use a pressure cooker, crock pot, instant pot, you could use garbanzo beans, and it would cost you about 58 to 75 cents depending on the beans. These beans were 58 cents per can. The 1 pound bag I got on sale for $1. So I got so much more beans out of it than I would with a can. So it makes it a lot cheaper. But again, it's just based on your time. If you don't have the time to make the beans, if you don't have the ability to make them, grab a can of beans. There's nothing wrong with that. But just giving you options, this meal is a lot cheaper if you make it with the dried beans. So once my beans were 66, I popped them off and they were absolute perfection. They always smell so good. I didn't add any seasonings to these because you're going to have to stop back on Tuesday to see what I do with the rest of these beans. One thing I really, really love about making pressure cooker beans or crock pot beans is I have so many then on hand to use, and then I usually plan my meal plan around it for the week. Like I said, I have more recipes coming on Tuesday. I am using my Dutch oven, but you can just use a regular pan or whatever you want for your stovetop, and adding about 50 cents worth of an onion, and then I'm using homemade veggie broth, which I will share the recipe here at the end and link it down below to my blog, so that way you have it if you want to keep it. And all I do is add a little bit of veggie broth instead of oil. I started cooking with veggie broth when we were on our debt-free journey just because it was free and I didn't have to buy oil, and I just kind of kept up with it. So then I'm going to add to that about 50 cents worth of carrots. I just had some baby carrots sitting in my crisper, so that's what I used, and I will also link this 3-in-1 blender down below if you need a handy kitchen tool. It's cordless. It's awesome. You charge it and then it literally stays charged for forever, and it's so handy. Then you don't have to get out your big food processor, or you don't have to chop anything if you don't want to. So then I added the carrots also to the pot and cooked them again with veggie broth. It's just an easy way to saute or steam your veggies, and I just cook them until everything's mildly tender. It doesn't have to be perfect. Once the onion's translucent and the carrots have cooked for about 2 to 4 minutes, it's perfect because the carrots are going to have time to cook later on in the recipe. I also added some salt, oregano, and basil. You can add Italian seasoning if you have it. I was completely out, which is shocking. I just use a lot of Italian seasoning in my house and in my cooking. And then, like I said, I just sauteed them probably between 3 and 5 minutes total, adding a little extra veggie broth just so the carrots had a little bit of liquid to cook down. This was one of those meals that I threw together last second on a very busy weeknight, and I was shocked by the outcome. Honestly, it's one of the best meals that I have made in a long time. It is so delicious, so budget friendly, and I love that there was leftovers. So then to that, once I was satisfied with the cooking method of the veggies, I added 2 cups of the garbanzo beans. I still have 4 more cups left, which is crazy. I also added 2 tablespoons of cornstarch once this started to kind of cook up a little bit, almost when it became a boil, because I wanted to give it a nice thickening method. I am going to add coconut milk as well, and I'll share a secret with you with coconut milk, but adding a little bit of cornstarch really is a secret to this recipe, so it's nice and thick and creamy instead of just kind of being really brothy. So I added that, stirred it in, and then like I said, I have a secret for you for coconut milk. So I usually get my coconut milk at Trader Joe's. However, recently at the dollar store, I've been finding these little 3-packs for $1, and I found them because someone else on Instagram said that's where they get their coconut milk. And honestly, it's a great price. I put it in the refrigerator. That's why it's so thick and creamy, and make it cold. So it's almost like a whipped cream or a heavy cream before adding it to my pot. And I find that it just makes everything so much richer and creamier. And I love adding it in this way. But that with the cornstarch makes this so creamy. I go ahead and stir it up so it's nice and mixed together, and then I added 1 cup of orzo. You can add any kind of noodle you want. Orzo is a little bit more expensive, especially if you do it gluten-free, but this was really the rock star of this entire meal. And then I popped the lid on and I let it simmer for 10 minutes on low. Because it's a Dutch oven, I feel like it keeps the heat in really, really nice, and it cooks everything nice and evenly and fast, and so you can cook on a lower heat, which I really like. After 10 minutes, I went ahead and pulled the lid off, and it was absolute perfection. $2.92 on this ginormous meal. It fed us for multiple meals. We had it for dinner, and then we had it for lunch the next day and dinner the next night. And you can serve it with a nice crusty loaf of bread. You're going to see a bread recipe next, and that bread loaf cost roughly 50 cents to make. So here are the leftover garbanzo beans. Like I said, make sure you subscribe so you can see on Tuesday what I make with these. You're not going to want to miss it because I have some great recipes coming. As you may know by now, I love making bread, and I decided this day to make two loaves to kind of get a jump start on the week ahead. And I can always make more later in the week, but this way it's already pre-made. I kind of had a schedule for the meal plan that I was chatting with you guys about. So I did a nutritional yeast Italian seasoning one, so it was like a cheesy Italian, and I just did a regular traditional loaf. The traditional loaf I ended up giving away, so I made it ahead to help myself out, but then I was like, you know what? I'm going to gift this loaf of bread. So anyways, I ended up making another one the next day. But hey, I was able to make 6 loaves of bread with this one thing of flour. Anyways, if you've never made homemade bread, this is the easiest one to start with. 3 cups of water, a teaspoon of salt, some seasonings if you want to add it in, 1.5 cups of warm water. You mix it together, you let it sit. If you have the quick active yeast, you can let it sit for 1 hour. It's even better if you let it sit for longer just because that yeast just kind of has time to really rise and really blossom. But it still works out really good. You still have a really crusty, chewy loaf of bread if you let it sit for an hour. So it's completely up to you and your time frame. A lot of times I will make these loaves at night and let them sit overnight. If you have a warm house, it will also rise a little faster. With bread making, the biggest thing I like to tell people who've never made bread before, it's really, really easy to follow a recipe. But depending on the climate you live in, that recipe may or may not work out, which I think sometimes scares people because I have people that will tag me over on Instagram and be like, okay, I made your bread, but it was so sticky. And then I just let them know like, hey, you just need a little bit more flour. You might live in a really humid climate. I live in a really dry climate, so my bread tends to be a little bit drier. And you just kind of go with trial and error, but you're not going to mess it up. If it's sticky, add a little bit more flour. If it's really, really dry, add a little bit more water. And as you can see, when I add my water, I add a little at a time. And I'll show you here real quick. I didn't even add 1.5 cups because I know what my bread's supposed to look like. The crockpot bread I made a couple weeks ago, I added 2 cups of water because that was the recipe and I just assumed it needed more water because it was going in the crockpot, so it was super, super sticky. But the next time I made it with 1.5 cups and it was fine. So this dough is a little bit drier. Yes, it could have added more water, but again, I know what it should look like. And sometimes when you add seasonings into this dough, it tends to be a little bit drier. And you'll see my rise really isn't that great. My kitchen was kind of chilly this morning. It's just because we don't have any carpet in our downstairs. We do have higher ceilings. And on a chilly morning, our downstairs is sometimes chilly because it's just the way I have my heat set, the preference of my house. You could definitely, like I said, move it to a warmer room if you want a better rise. But my bread turned out perfect. And I think it's really, really important to share with you guys different kinds of weather making bread so you don't see that my bread always looks the same. As you can see, it's a little bit dry. I liked it that way. I knew it was perfect by the texture of it. I let it rest for about an hour, let it rise. Like I said, you can do it overnight, 6 to 8 hours, whichever works for you. This bread could not be any easier to make. You go ahead and preheat your oven to 450 degrees, and then you're gonna actually pop your bread pan in. Here, I'll explain it to you. Okay, we're doing 2 different kinds of breads, and I'm not going to do my Dutch oven because I wanna show a couple different methods. So into the preheating oven, we're going to put 1 of these bread pans and 1 glass baking dish. If you have a Dutch oven, you can go ahead and add the bottom, not the lid, of your Dutch oven into your oven and let that preheat. It makes it so that it gets nice and hot and then the bread doesn't stick. You don't need any additional oils or sprays and you get a nice crispy, crunchy crust, which is perfect for soups and toast and bread and croutons and literally everything. And I don't need my bread. I just kind of fold it like an envelope. I saw that on YouTube once and I absolutely love it. The texture of my bread is perfect. It may not look like it got a huge rise. It doesn't matter. I know what it's supposed to feel like. I know what it's supposed to look like, and this is perfect. So this one I'm making into a quote-unquote traditional style loaf, like a loaf you would buy at the grocery store that you would slice up, kind of that rectangular shape, and then the traditional loaf that's like unflavored, it's just like a traditional white bread. I'm actually making that in a round loaf, and I think these both turned out so beautiful. You're going to see at the end, but again, I kind of fold it like an envelope or in 4. It was told an envelope, But now that I'm looking at it, I can't see the envelope. So anyways, and then I kind of roll this one up into a ball and kind of pinch it under. You can also do a second rise if you want to. It's totally not necessary because it's ready to go. And then all I'm going to do is pat it a little bit because I think it's fun. You don't have to do this because you are going to plop it into the pan. But these are looking so good already, and I love the way that my kitchen smells when I'm making yeasty breads. Even though I don't enjoy it anymore, I know what this bread tastes like. I ate it every single day during our debt payoff journey, I feel like. We always made it. I make it now for my husband. So once my oven's preheated, I go ahead and take my pans out. And for this one, I'm doing a lid with another bread pan. It's great. It worked for me for almost a year when I was making this bread and I didn't have a Dutch oven. Pop it in the oven for 30 minutes, then take the lid off for an additional 15. And then go ahead with this one. I'm going to put it in a glass baking dish just to show a different method. And then you're going to cover it with just a piece of aluminum foil. It doesn't have to be on there tight or anything. You just kind of make sure it's a little bit on there so it can kind of steam a little bit like a lid. Pop that in there for 30 minutes. And then 30 minutes later, you're going to take them out, take the lids off, put them back in for 15 minutes. If you have not made this bread, you are missing out. You need to make it ASAP.
Ooh, so pretty. Look how perfect. I love this split right here. It makes me so happy. I love the little dusting of flour. So here's my traditional loaf, and here's my round loaf. As you can see, this one is a little bit crispier already, but no need to worry. They're gonna go back in for 15 minutes and get nice and crispy on the top, and then they're gonna fully cool and be ready to eat.
Let me know in a comment below, are you so excited to get into your kitchen and start baking bread? If you guys haven't seen the pull apart pizza bread that Kale Junkie shared not too long ago, I highly recommend trying it. That's what I made the round loaf with. I made a pizza bread for my neighbors and they loved it. It was a huge hit. They had a party the other night. It was awesome. So highly recommend giving that a try. It would be a great dinner. You could stuff it with whatever the heck you wanted. This bread is such a cheap way to make any meal more elegant, so I hope you start adding it onto your meals.
Well, no makeup, glasses, and it's early in the morning. And I don't normally show up on YouTube like this, but you guys are my best friends. What can I say? We're gonna make some veggie broth with the scraps that I have been saving for the past week. This is about a perfect amount to put in my crock pot, so I'm gonna share with you what I do. Sometimes you do crock pot method. I have as of recently. Sometimes I do stovetop, but honestly, the crock pot method is really nice because I can just set it in there and forget about it. Come back 6 hours later, perfect broth.
First, thank you so much for letting me feel open to come on here as my real raw self. Wet hair, glasses, no makeup. Second, if you make any snarky comment about it, you can't be my best friend anymore. I know none of us get into the kitchen camera ready every single time we come into our kitchen, but it feels very vulnerable to do so here on YouTube.